Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is the first tutorial of CSS. In this tutorial I'm going to give a complete introduction of CSS. I made it long, but the alternative was really to make four videos, three videos, all of the same, of different topics, very short. So I made this video like this. First I want to show you the difference between, this is one of the pages with only HTML, and of course is really unpresentable to the World Wide Web. It's a poor page with nothing, no beauty and no style, even if it works. And if you see this page, which is a normal page, you can see this is much more presentable. And of course, all these fonts, all these images, all these fonts, the character of the text, is all a feature of all feature of CSS, and that's why we need it. How do we insert CSS inside a page? CSS can be inserted in two ways, in three ways actually, but or from an external source. Here we have nothing, but we have the CSS file to insert. And how do we insert it? In the head, in the head part, you write link, this rel style sheet, it means nothing in particular, but is needed, and then href, and then you type file.css, and then is linked with the page. If you want to have the for example, you want to write what you've wrote on file.css, you want to write it here, you can, and you just need to do like this, and you just need to do like this, then you write what you want. And okay, so what's the difference between the two? You can even write it here. You can even write it in line, and you write it, and then you give whatever. Anyway, is another possibility that you have. We will see when it's really recommended to use. Anyways, the least possible case scenario. Anyway, what's the difference between these two? The first one, you can copy and paste your code very easily. I mean, you create your CSS file, then you have, for example, five different web pages, and you want to use the same font style. Okay, you copy and paste this link, and that's it. This one is more troublesome to copy and paste, but maybe you want, for example, in this page, you want this header written in yellow, then the other page you want it written in red. So here you can copy and paste this long thing, which can be huge, like an entire page. But then once you copy and paste it, you just change some particular parts, and then you make little changes that according to what you want to do. I think that when you begin a project, I generally start with this, also because I can use only one page, and so it's more comfortable, etc. Yes, about how to use it in line, for example, inside the text, it's I think you will never use it, but here is normal. You write style, for example, then you write color, double quote, and then you choose your color. And this, I hope, colors the random page. So it's something you can do, and we will see all these things in the next videos. We will cover all the topics, etc. And of course, yes, this is an inline CSS. Okay, so how CSS work in practice? I mean, what's the process, no? So this is very good, a good explanation. First, the browser loads the HTML, so it takes the HTML and it loads it, then it reads it, then at the same time it creates the DOM and loads the CSS, then it parses the CSS, so it reads the CSS, and then it attaches the CSS style to the DOM tree. And then it displays what's displayed which is the web page. So the question is, what is the DOM? Of course, the DOM, I start saying DOM is this one, but probably you already know it. This is the DOM, so is the HTML in itself, but not on cioè not only is this one, but what's the DOM in theory? The DOM is called the Document Object Model and is a representation of using nodes of everything that you have in your web page. This is the definition, the official definition. So everything that you have become nodes. You have your head, your body, and inside the body you have style, you have H1 and P, H1, H2, H3, and all these become nodes which are linked to each other. And of course we have the root node, which is parent to nodes. To, for example, HTML is parent of head, and title is child of head, and head is child of the HTML. This is what they say. We will cover this in the next lesson for sure. We will talk about cascade and the heritage. Anyway. Yes, this is it. And of course, head and body are siblings. This is the three main definitions. And all these are linked to become nodes of themselves. And it's important to say that text and elements for the DOM are two different things, because you see the text, for example, no? In the pages you see the text, but you don't see title, you see only text or something like this. And so yes, they are two different things, etc. We will cover this in the following videos, etc., etc. So what we have to cover now? What happens if we make mistakes in CSS? For example, the answer is just nothing, because it's just nothing, because if you misspell it will not be loaded. I can show you an example, why not? If you do that, H1 style color, blue, and it will be colored in blue. But if I write, for example, blue, it will just load the page as it is. It won't read the code. It doesn't throw errors. So So in a way it's good because it means that if you make a mistake, nothing really happens. In others, sometimes you make mistakes and then you don't know that you'd made it. Maybe you forgot that you have wrote it, etc., etc. Anyway, nothing happens if you mistake CSS. Simply the code doesn't get executed. Yes, let's. I can show you a little, for example, a little piece of code. Maybe I've write it one second. Okay, so sorry, I stopped and wrote this just because I wanted to show you. We already talked in the HTML course about span and div, which are wrappers that are non-semantic wrappers, and we didn't talk more about this. Why we call it non-semantic? Because they have no structure. And theoretically in it themselves, for only HTML, they mean nothing. So, of course, their use case is to be linked with HCSS. And here it is. Now I've wrote that span will color the background of the text in blue. And now, if you go on in the text and you write span, you will see that now it has this feature, and so you can with span and div you can make the characteristic that you want. You can craft your own functions. Now it's wrong to say like this, but yes, you can create your own rules for span and div and then use it on the text. Okay, so we have arrived at the end. Last thing I want to show you is version of the browsers, because of course nothing is perfect and internet is not perfect, so some places for example, some features of CSS are supported by some browsers and others not. Let's see this CSS grid. Probably you don't know what it is, it doesn't matter. And here it appears this table. This website you will probably use it a lot if you will develop and do web design or something like this. And here there are all the browsers from Chrome, Edge, Safari, Opera. I don't know if there is something missing, but I don't think so. And all these has their own versions, no? So if we see here, for example, Internet Explorer, which is one of the oldest, and it says that is not supported, partial support with prefix. Anyway, as you see, not everything is supported here, and it's something that you have to consider while you develop, because if you use a CSS class function and you see that something is not supported, if we write here, for example, background color, I think it will be supported almost everywhere, but maybe not somewhere exactly. For example, background color is something you will do for sure, you will use for sure, but you have to know that for in Opera Mobile is not supported, and this means that you should write some fallback for some features or something like this. Because you have to reach all the customers that you want. Also, one of the common mistakes is to think that Internet Explorer is not used anymore in the world, but it's absolutely not true. Here you can even see global usage and it's not even that small. And of course, this presents 0.4. It's not very very small. It means that generally Internet Explorer is used with the Windows 7, Windows 7, less than Windows 10. And as you see, it's not very small, and it causes problem on many things. So you have to use this tool, this caniuse.com, to have a look what can cause problems, to what, or if you need to use some other things. Anyway, yes, have a look at this site. It's quite useful. And that's it for this lesson. I'm going to, in the following next session, we are going to discuss about cascades and heritage, what we said about parent and child, and some more. I hope you enjoyed, and of course, keep watching my videos, subscribe to my channel, and etc. etc. Thank you very much. See you soon.